To look at this crop, you wouldn't know Queensland's dryland peanut growers have just had their worst season on record. While drought stopped many crops from making it this far, this one survived and, in comparison, thrived. It's a variety called Redvale, and it illustrates the positive impact of including early maturing peanut varieties in the breeding program.
We've been looking at the shorter season varieties to try and either get planted early and mitigate end of season droughts, or have the ability to plant late if you don't get planting rain until late in the season.
Ultra early varieties, maturing a month earlier than their full season cousins, provide a safeguard for growers, allowing them to spread risk and achieve a return even in poor seasons.
They are lower yielding in a very good year, so there is a penalty in better years, but in drier years they'll always give you something, you know. So this year is a very good example of that.
Improvements in ultra-early varieties are a key focus of the Australian Peanut Genetic Improvement Program, a joint collaboration between the Peanut Company of Australia, DAF Queensland and GRDC. It's an investment that's paying off.
So this is the progression in pod size that we've made over the last 10 years. So you can see this is the first release, Walter, fairly small pod size, and through to Tingura, which was released in 2010. Then Redvale in 2013, and through to P23, which is a breeding line currently being tested at the moment. But you can see the massive increase in pod size that we've been able to make over that period of time.
Vic Richardson, whose family has been farming near Kingaroy for more than a century, was glad he planted ultra-early variety Redvale this past season.
You get much bigger bush than the previous one of Tingura. You can get a lot of jumbos, and that's where the good money is.
Redvale's synchronous pod setting is associated with up to 10% higher kernel yield and 5% more jumbo kernels than Tingura, providing benefits of $200 to $500 per hectare depending on the season.
We're now getting to the stage where the ultra earlies can actually deliver a yield and grade similar to the full season varieties. And I think what we're seeing with the Redvale, if that continues on with the next one, that determinacy of the crop to actually set a good even crop, which then means more even grading, more high quality, high paying kernels, then that's certainly on the right track.
Additional ultra earlies due for release in 3 years promise further benefits.
They've made a quantum leap in yield even over Redvale. So, you know, we're talking probably another 10, even 20% better yield and a lot larger kernel as well. And also disease resistance. So we've been able to get a lot of the leaf disease tolerance into these varieties as well.
With disease resistance high on the wish list for both dryland and irrigated peanut growers, that's a welcome addition. And for an update on breeding progress against leaf spot, leaf rust and net blotch, check out part 2 of this video by following the link on screen.